Hello again, my name is Michelle and welcome to a new edition of the Meet the Expert vlog. Today's topic is all about robotics, which is a hot topic nowadays as technology is improving and labor is becoming scarce. Currently, I'm working on a customer myself who would like to incorporate robotics into their design. Therefore, I'm especially excited to tell more about this topic today together with my colleagues. As I just mentioned, labor scarcity is becoming an increasingly challenged nowadays. Of course, Vanderlande has already helped many customers all around the world in reducing the number of people they need inside of their logistics by adding highly automated solutions. But we can take it one step further. Therefore, I'm going to talk to my colleague Tessa, who knows all about how Vanderlande is implementing robotics. Hey Tessa.
Hi Michelle.
Hey.
Nice to see you.
Yeah, nice to see you too. So what are the latest developments on robotics? And for example, what are you working on at the moment?
Yes, so actually there's happening quite a lot at Vanderlande within the field of robotics. We are applying robotics within airports, but also within parcel and warehousing systems. And today I believe is all about robotic item picking, which is basically the robot picking items from bin to bin or from bin to a carton, for example. Mm-hmm. So this robot can actually become the new member of your team.
Okay, and what about the maturity of this technology?
So over the past years, the technology has matured quite a lot. With the increase in e-commerce and also labor shortage, we have seen the demand for robotic item picking applications increase. While at the same time, the computer technology, AI systems, but also cameras and grippers have really improved. So robotic item picking has improved exponentially and is now ready to be implemented in warehouses on a large scale.
But we don't develop this in-house, do we?
No, indeed. So we have tested the world's leading robot picking solutions and selected only the very best to work with. And we fully integrate these into the end-to-end warehouse solutions for our customers. And in that way, they become fully part of our customers' operations.
Okay, interesting. Thanks a lot, Tessa. And see you next time.
Yeah, you're welcome. See you.
Bye. We are now going to the Innovation Center, where we have a test setup with our item picking robot. We use this setup to test customer products and to integrate it into our goods-to-person workstation. Hi Dennis.
Hey Michelle.
I'm here to have a look at our item picking robot. Could you explain a little bit more on how it works?
Yes, this is our smart item robot, in particular selected for picking general merchandise items.
Yeah.
And this robot actually works with brains and hands, and also with vision, with eyes.
Yeah, so it is almost a copy of a human, let's say.
Indeed, you can see it like that. So the cameras, they take an image and they convert that to the brains, and they start computing, motion planning, and also a segmentation of the items. And this is transferred to the arm and the hand to actually execute the pick, even without teaching the robot.
Okay, so it just sees a product maybe for the first time and then starts picking.
Indeed.
Could you give some more specifics about this robot? For example, the performance, like what it can pick and how fast?
Yes, let's get closer to the robot so I can explain some things.
Yes.
So if you now enter the cell and you approach the robot, you will encounter the safety device.
Oh yes, it stops straight
now
away.
Now it stops working. Yeah. So coming back to your question, this robot is capable of picking items with a surface up to 250 by 250 millimeters.
Okay.
And with a payload of a maximum of 1.5 kilograms. And if you send the right items to this robot, it can pick up to 900 picks per hour robot-only capacity.
Okay, yeah, that's quite a lot. But I can imagine the robot is not able to pick everything.
No, indeed. Items with a porous surface, they cannot be picked up because this robot needs suction to be able to pick an item up. Mm-hmm. And also items with size and weight outside of the boundaries I just told you, they simply cannot be picked up because they get lost from the gripper.
So how do you deal with these kind of challenges?
Well, this is exactly where we as an integrator come in. Mm-hmm. We need to assist our customers in sending the right items and orders to the robot station.
Yeah.
In order to make the pick successful. And in terms of equipment, we have intelligent software to sequence the right orders to the robot to be as efficient as we can be. And additionally to that, we can add features to our systems to make sure that we track and solve possible mistakes of the robot.
All right. You know what? I'll pay my colleague, Bram, a visit. He's also a sales engineer, and he can show a bit more on how this robot is integrated into a total solution.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Good luck.
Hi, Bram.
Hi, Michelle.
I just spoke to Tessa and Dennis about our item picking robot, and they said it is very important how to integrate this robot into the total solution to get optimal use of the robot. How do you see this?
Yeah, I fully agree. To make optimal use of our smart item robot, it is essential that it is integrated in a total warehouse solution. For example, items need to be supplied to the pick robot, and the same applies for the order carriers. Mm-hmm. If the items and order carriers are not supplied to the picking robot, it is simply not possible to do its task and pick the items. So that's why we typically see these robots integrated in highly automated solutions like our fast pick concept.
So you told me the other day that you're now working on a fast pick solution, goods to person. So could you show me and maybe explain a little bit what this looks like?
Yes, of course, Michelle. On the screen, you see a typical layout of our fast pick solution. Mm-hmm. This layout has been created for one of our customers in Northern Europe. And you see here at the heart of the system, you see the Adapto ASRS shuttle system. On the right of the shuttle system, there you see the decanting area. The decanting area is used to replenish our shuttle system. Mm-hmm. So you can see here a set of workstations where we bring full pallets of goods towards these decanting operators.
Yeah.
The decanting operators, they take the content of the pallet and place the items into the tote. And then via the conveyor system, we store those totes in the adaptive shuttle system. And once the totes are in the adaptive shuttle system, the items are available for picking. Mm-hmm. It's the responsibility of the Adapto shuttle system to sort and sequence basically the product totes towards the right workstations.
Yeah.
And the workstations are here located in the front of the Adapto system.
But when I look at this, not every workstation is equipped with an item picking robot.
Yes, that's correct. So if you look closely, you see six robot workstations and mm-hmm. two normal goods to person workstations with a human operator. Of course, not all items are pickable by a robot. So with our intelligent software, we try to plan items that are robot pickable. Those items we send to the robot cells, mm-hmm. and items that we cannot pick by the robot, those items will be sent to the normal goods to person station and will be picked by the human operator.
Nice demonstration, Bram. Here you really see how you fully utilize the robots and maximize their performance.
That's right, Michelle.
What we have learned today is that we have taken the next step by adding item picking robots to our automated solutions. And robots don't need any breaks. Of course, robots are not a one-on-one replacement of humans. But by smartly integrating them, we can make optimal use of these robots. I can imagine that you have more questions about our warehousing activities, so feel free to place them into the comments. And of course, don't forget to press the like button. I hope to see you on the next Meet the Expert vlog, but maybe next time a robot can do the interviewing and I can just have breaks.